Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what is up, and welcome back to the World Series of Poker. We are doing very well this year. Very steady, kind of a little steady incline of events here. Damn, I really want to play that. Ah! Oh, we gotta do pot limit hold'em. Damn it. I love World Championships. Whenever it says World Championship, I get excited. But then, like, I understand that it's not really, like, a title or a championship like in wrestling. Or maybe it is. I don't know. If I ever win the World Series of Poker main event, I'm gonna convert the bracelet into a championship belt. And then I will wear it around all the time. I'll have a briefcase to carry it. That's what I would do. I would convert the bracelet into my own creation, probably devaluing it by quite a bit, but yeah, I don't know. Or maybe I could just keep the bracelet and then customize a belt that would look almost exactly like the bracelet, but bigger. I think that's a better idea, because then I have the bracelet as well, just in case, you know, I die and it becomes a collector's item, something like that. All right, 10 jack. This is pot limit. Pretty much a turbo tournament. Now, again, if you have not played internet poker, you don't know what I'm saying when I say turbo. What I mean by turbo is, look, that raise is 375. That means Alan Edwards is a crazy person. He is betting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times the big blind, which is maybe if you had aces or kings. Or ace king suited. That's what you would be raising 375 for. So yeah, turbo tournaments online, they are often filled with fish, which are people who are playing silly cards and people who just want to go all in on the first hand and get a huge chip stack at the beginning. Turbo tournaments, I believe, the key for a turbo tournament is to get the biggest stack as possible and just bully the whole table. I feel like that's the only way to do it, and I perfectly just now got a, not a free flop, but a very, very cheap flop, which is awesome. No diamonds, I got a queen, that's no good. So we probably lost this one here. Look at this, 250 call. How nice. Not gonna be me. I'm not gonna deal with it. Let's see what's up next. See, look at that. Just betting almost all of their chips on one hand. Queen four, big blind. We get a raise here. I'm not gonna defend with queen four. Really, I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna bide my time and go all in and try to get some real money out of these people. See, Norm, I believe, called or raised with five deuce suited, which is insane.
Going to fourth straight.
And now he's behind in a big way. He needs a five or a deuce. Ah, now he's done. Norm Walker loses. Tim Lewis doubles up.
In the side.
All right, deuce jack. Not going to do that. Look at that. 225, 225, 225, 225. My goodness. And then a re-raise. And then Allen goes all in and they all fold. That's turbo. It's craziness, although usually on the internet somebody will just go, yeah, I'll go all in, and it'll be like four people all in. It's insane. Ace-queen is good, I'm in the dealer position, I've got the best position on the table, and I'm gonna go with ace-queen. Ace-queen's a scary combination, but in turbo, I'll take what I can get. I like ace-queen. Even now, it's two over cards. See, now being the position of the dealer, I get to see what they do first. Now, I could go over the top. He's only at 1750. He's only at 1800, excuse me. He's only at 1800. I could go all in. Would he call it? Probably. He probably has a 9. Would I hit an ace or a queen? Probably. But I don't know that for sure. It's not worth it. I fold. I'm not looking to get lucky in poker. I'm looking to win. And when you're unsure, when you have just that maybe 40% chance of losing, you do not want to call. 310 queen, queen 10, ace 10, queen 10 in the lead. Paige desperately needs an ace here, or runner straight cards.
The six of hearts.
She needs an ace and only an ace. Doesn't happen. A double up for Richard Edwards. Alright, A7. Pretty good, but, I mean, in turbo, I don't think it's great. It's kind of a junk hand. Especially with this many people in the hand, it's something a lot of people like to play, because it's an ace, and a 7 isn't that low of a number. But it's a huge mistake to play, especially in the position I was in. I feel.
Let's see what they've got.
Alright, ace king, 10-9.
The turn.
There's the ace.
The king of heart.
There's the king.
Two pair now.
And ooh, there's really no hope unless he hits a 10.
He
it's over. Tim Lewis
the
gone.
The good news is he doubled up. The bad news is that he...
You know what? Nah. I was going to actually play it, but that
pretty
raise of 700 was
move.
Way too much. I mean, think about it. That's four... That's like four and a half times the big blind, which is crazy. What a crazy bet. And then Norm goes all in. We really just have to wait for the right opportunity here and get extremely lucky.
According to
maybe make a well-timed bluff and go all in is perhaps something that we should consider doing as well. Maybe not with 10-6, but something like ace-8. No. Something that has some dangerous potential, like this. This is a good one to go all in with. First, let's call, and let's see if Randy will like to come along. I don't want
to
go all in with king-queen, because it might get beat. But, I mean, right now we're pretty much chip-invested. We probably should go all in anyway.
Three of a kind on the board.
Okay, I check. Yikes. We might be playing horse.
That's
I call.
He's going all
I call
in.
With king high. Let's see.
Let's
what's
see
he
what
got?
They have,
sixes, ace
he
ten. Oh, I'm in
house.
Trouble. I need a
that's
king or a queen. A king or
and
a queen here.
Turn.
So I mean, I've got an opportunity.
The ace of diamonds.
Oh, it's
he
over.
Gets the full
I can't
Anchors
win.
Away.
Page needs a six.
Last card being dealt.
Yeah, double knockout
sometimes
for Randy. That's what I was scared of. I was scared of a pocket pair and an ace high, and that's exactly what they had. Turbo tournaments, man. They're killer. They are killer. And we wasted 2,500 there? Yuck. Alright, now this is scary. We're playing the World Championship for horse. Let me go back through the history. I don't remember the history. Damn it. Let me get my notes. I still haven't filled this stuff out, so if we bust out early, I think I'll update this. And we'll just leave it at that today. I'm pretty sure the first one was Johnny Chan. Phil Gordon won it in year 3. Johnny Chan won it in year 1. Year 2 we don't know about. And here we are in year 4, so let's see if we can win the Horse World Championship. It's a World Championship, I'm excited. I like I said earlier, I get excited with World Championships. It makes me quite excited. I'm trying to shuffle cards. Here's the deal. So you guys remember my back pain. There were many episodes. Oh, we're playing Scotty Wynn. He's a former horse champion in real life, I believe. I think he is. We'll call. So with my back pain, it's very strange. I can't feel my pinky almost ever. It's almost always numb, which scares me a lot, but the pain
that's
is subsiding, and I'm not going to go to the hospital unless I have to. I'm a little nervous. Okay, that bet was smaller than the bring-in, wasn't it? And I have two over cards. I'll call.
Flush draw and
I'm out.
All right, Skip, you got it. So this is going
to
be interesting because it's 50,000, and the blinds right now are just kind of 25, 50, 5,000, 10... So we have, like, what, 20 big blinds?
Players are gonna have...
Or 200 big blinds, I think. So, yeah, so limits right now are 500. Yeah, it's like 100 big blinds. My goodness. Oh, man. 500. 100. 100 big blinds.
Let's take a look at what they're hiding. Courtesy of
my math
the
is off.
Hole card.
So we're gonna go zooming through this first part of horse because
oh,
the antes... And the bring-ins and the limits are very, very low. Not the bring-ins, I keep saying bring-ins. The small blind, the big blind, and the antes are pretty low at this point. And we're just going to try to win as many hands as possible, just to give us that slight advantage.
With a flop like that,
this is the type of tournament where you could not show up for the first maybe two levels, and then show up in the third level, and be totally fine. and it might actually be more worth it, not showing up, because you may just blow up early on and get on tilt. Whereas if you stay away from the tournament, you know, these people blow each other up and they take each other out and they waste more money than they earn, and they screw themselves over. Phil Hellmuth in the main event does that quite a bit, where he will show up late.
Wow.
I think it's mostly because he just doesn't... he probably just doesn't think that... I mean, him with any chip, like a chip in a chair type situation, I think him in that situation, he believes he could still win the main event. Beautiful. I got my set. I love it. So that's why I think he shows up late. But I think a lot of people sometimes show up late on purpose. I remember on Full Tilt... Ooh, we need to be careful of a straight here and a flush. Okay, I'm not nervous of that. Sometimes on Full Tilt Poker, there would be a late registration, and I hated that. I could not stand late registration. Because people would wait, and then they would just wait for, like, 30 or 40 people to bust out, and then they would be right there, and they'd have a chip stack, and it's like they're starting from step one, and I just don't like that. I like, if you're not on time and you're not registered, I don't like that. I don't like that. Makes me mad. I don't like late registration. Rebuys, I think, are funny and ridiculous. I mean, we'll talk a little bit more about that when we get to it, when we get past year 10 in this series, and we start playing some internet poker on my website.
Here comes the flop.
And that'll be more exciting. I think that'll be really fun. I mean, right now I'm struggling making up thumbnails and stuff because not much is different, you know what I mean?
And his stack gets a little larger with that heads-up win.
There's not much different.
One stack
in each episode. I mean, I could say we're playing against Scotty Wynn again, but I'm pretty sure I've already put him in a thumbnail. Maybe one of the first couple, maybe three or four videos, I think I put him in a thumbnail. So, I mean, it's just starting to repeat, and I don't like that.
Some bling, Norman?
Ooh, look at that. So we got trips. We got a set here. I'm just going to call. I want a king. I mean, we've got a really good hand here. Very strong. A queen will give us a straight. I don't like the diamonds. What I want is a 5-9 jack or king. That's what I want. 5-9 jack or king. Oh, man.
Another call.
Yeah, we're going to pay full price here. 5-9 jack or king here to give me a full house.
Lon, you need a strong stomach to
preferably a 9-5. Oh, that's no good. So I'm really nervous of a flush, so we'll let it go.
They clearly needed to bet harder
to
scare the table off.
Deuce 4 clubs. Yeah, see, that's why I didn't want the king. Wow, so I was beat. I was beat bad. There was really no card that would have helped me there. That sucks. We've got another... That's why I hate Omaha. There's so many different things. I mean, look at this. I've got an ace. That's good. But I also have queens. That's good, too. We've got two hearts. So we've got second nut flush here. Now we have a straight draw.
Some hearts out there.
There we go. So now we have the nut flush, which is great. So I'm going to raise.
We'll
the only thing that could beat
down.
Me is if she has king 7, king bet. Deuce, king ace. And she does not. Oh, he does not. I'm sorry. I wasn't looking up
at
the people.
The
and we win. Good. All right. I'm actually going to fold this time. We do have a pocket pair again, which is great, but I'm going to give it a break.
sure
I'm going to give it a break.
Raise.
It's fours. I mean, we don't have really any strong helping cards. We'll let it go.
Some possible.
10 jack, queen, king. Full house. Kimpole.
I'll make a bet here.
Ooh, Raz. I love Raz. Deuce 4 under is great. We will call. Ooh.
Everybody checks.
So far, Hugh's beating me. Ooh, I fold.
I'm out.
We've been practicing for this tournament, man. We've been practicing for this. Our Raz game is off the hook. All right, I'm going to raise here because I want Kim and Megan gone. Good. 7-8, deuce 9. All right, I just call this one. Right now I've got a 97. 10-9. But he has a queen, so I might still be in a good shape here. Okay, so I still have a 10-9. Now I officially have a 10-9. And he's got to have at least a 10-8. So I might be in the lead. I don't know. I'm going to put some money in the pot just in case. I mean, if I get an ace, 3-4. Oh, wow. He just folds. Really? Okay.
Let's take a look at what they're hiding, courtesy of the Bluff Magazine.
All right, we got a 3 showing here. I see some low cards, so I'm going to let it go. I didn't think that they would all fold. They did. 5-4. Okay, those low hands folded. I don't know what game they think they're playing, so I will raise. The queen re-raises us. That's interesting.
All right.
So we know whatever she has under, even if it's ace-deuce, we're winning because we do have a jack and she has a queen. All right, so she's got queen 7, and I've got jack 9, so I'm winning. So let's put some money in the pot. Let's build some equity in Raz. Ooh, that's no good. Now she might be winning, so we're gonna let her take the lead. Now I think she's won it. The best thing I could get right now is a deuce or even an ace, and that still gives me a jack 9, and I don't think that's good enough to beat her, so I'm going to fold out. She wins this round. Anytime, Ginger King. Anytime. We see one-time bracelet winner, the Ginger King. Ooh. Oh, it's still Raz. That's a shame. I thought it was,
Local.
I thought it was, 7 card. Alright, so the jack raises us. I'm still gonna call because the 8s aren't pairing up, aren't crucially bad for us at the moment. That's bad. The king is bad. The king's very bad. That's good. And he's paired his jack, so as far as he knows, we might be in the lead here. Ooh. Oh, now I have a king 10. I check. I give up.
Not just anybody can win this many hands.
Oh no. Oh no. That would have been horrible if it was 7 card. I would have lost. Alright, so we got 3 hearts here. This is great. So now we're into 7 card. That's a very crucial thing about horse. 7 card and Raz play almost exactly the same way, but in reverse. So now we're looking to get the highest card combination. And we've got 3 hearts.
Could be slow playing.
We've got ace queen under. There are a lot of things we could hit. Okay. I might give up here. We didn't hit our hearts, and I don't like that, so we'll let it go. 7 card stud, let's fold that hand. No one crucially in danger right now, everyone kind of fluctuating. Like I said, you can skip the first few levels of any huge tournament like this and be fine. Ooh, ace deuce. I've got 6, 7, 8. I need a 9 or a 5. One of the 2 Dolly Partons, please. Oh, an 8's okay. It's okay. I'm not thrilled. I'm not over the moon about it.
Can't wait to see how this hand turns out. Call.
Let's see. Okay, king. Actually, we have a king
Anyone
flush
king?
Draw, which is pretty good. Alright, so we have 2 pair, and I like that. I feel like it's better than his ace, which I think he has. So let's see if we can beat his ace. We will call Ginger King. Thank you.
Awesome.
Yeah, exactly. That's kind of what I thought he had. And luckily he didn't pair up anything else, so we get another good win there. I'm going to raise here, because that deuce of clubs is weak. And the jack is gone, so the 6 is weak as well. I'm showing king of diamonds, which looks strong. And that's exactly what I wanted. I just wanted an easy pot. We'll let it go. We'll let Scotty win, just win one. High-low split, 3, 4, 6. Okay, we've got a low. Me and Scotty Win. I almost said Johnny Win. Scotty Win, battling it out. I check. There's no reason to be betting. We don't have a hand yet, Scotty. 3, 4, 6, 7. So we need an 8, a 5. I'm going to win low. I check. I'm at least going to win half. That's why I'm still in this. If any of you are confused, high-low split is a very fun game. It pretty much gives you a back-out option. Like, if you think you're going to lose, at least you have a low hand. Yeah, see, I had low. and he had queen high with a better kicker. He had queen 10, I had queen 9. So, we split at least a little bit of money between ourselves. With the antes and the bring in, I don't know who would have had the bring in. If he acted That's last, it was probably him. Let's see, 5. I'm actually going to raise Kim. She seems pretty tight.
I bet.
She is pretty tight. Yeah, and there we go. Man. No matter what we have, we'll just raise her and we'll take some easy money.
Another hand,
we are ballooning here, which is awesome. It's going right according to plan. This is another good high-low split Everybody starting falls. Hand, but it doesn't matter. They just give pot. It to us. Alright, 9-10. We get a raise, we get a call. 9-10, I'll fold. Out. Especially if Kim calls, because Kim's super tight. Alright, raise, call. Check, Last check, one. Raise.
No more.
Okay, queen of hearts. So no flushes.
Worst advice I ever got. Live
Sixes
like
are scary.
But I'll open anyway.
Brian raises. Skip re-raises. Battle of the old timers here.
It's only my
Brian Wallace, old Ronald McDonald. That's who good, he looks huh? like. And the trip sixes are gonna win. Actually, a full house queens over, or sixes over queens, and beats the two pair. Wow, that's unfortunate. The river really screwed him over. He was beaten the whole time. Brian Wallace really suffering here, and we're actually doing very well. Where are we at? We're at 46. We've played a lot of hands.
Hey, make sure all those chips. All right,
banana hand wins a pot. Ace Jack, I like it. I like Ace Jack. Ooh, raise, re-raise, call. I call as well. This is exciting. Huge pot already.
I'm not sure.
And I got trip aces. This is amazing. And a Jack is a pretty good kicker. I mean, this is really good. This is so intriguing. I don't know what's gonna happen here. I'm just gonna call.
I'll call.
This is kind of crazy. I don't know what's going on here. This is weird. Okay, I call. I've got three aces and a jack high. Three aces, king jack. That's my hand.
Ooh, can't wait to see how
what
this
can you beat me?
Out.
How can you beat me?
Norman, I'd say he looks displeased.
Oh, wow, nice hand. I'm not even mad because, I mean, it was very low possibility that he has an ace queen. Ace king. He could have had that, but I didn't think so.
I'd be more excited, but I'm considering the
Megan wins with a straight. We will fold. We didn't take too much of a hit. That's why I wasn't re-raising. I was kind of keeping that's pot good, control. Huh? Just in case. In the back of my mind, I kind of had a feeling that that's what Hugh had.
All right,
so I will call here. We've got ace 10, 10s, 9, 10 suited.
Board shows a pair of twos.
So far, our pocket 10s are the winning hand,
keep it interesting, at least.
And I'm going to raise. Try to get out that queen or something. Good, I like that card. I'm going to raise again.
Three of a kind on the board.
Perfect, so I have a full house. I'm going to raise. He's not betting on the river, which tells me I've got the best hand. And he just folds and gives it up, and we're back up to where we were. Beautiful. 3, 4, 6, 7. I don't like it. We have three diamonds. That's kind of gross. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go.
Yeah, that's what I was shooting.
By the way, if you haven't seen the movie Frozen, you should. It's a great movie. Don't let being cool and hip and old distract you from good stuff. Frozen's good stuff. Trust me. Best Disney movie in a very long time. Favorite part of the movie is I think he would be Swedish, right? I think so. His part in the movie, there's this small thing where they're lost in the wintry storm, and they go into this shack, and it sells all summer apparel, and there's a little bit of winter apparel, because it's usually a summer land, not a winter one. So the winter stuff's all used, it's all taken away, and it's all gone. And so as soon as you enter the story, he goes, yoo-hoo! It's just hilarious. I haven't been paying attention to this hand. That's very bad of me. Frozen messing things up. I've got a straight. I will check because the pot's plenty big enough for me. And it scares me that he's raising.
friendly cards
yeah,
led to
good.
A heads up pot, Norman.
Aces and sevens. I would have had aces and nada. So I'm happy I hit that last card to give me the straight there. I got extremely lucky. I was talking about...
Oh, well
yoo-hoo.
Played. You can take it.
Oh, say hello to my family. Yoo-hoo. Yoo-hoo. Oh, it makes me laugh. I love that scene. My nieces love it. Or my nieces and nephews love it. It's a great movie. You should go see it.
That's right, baby. That's
if you
no
haven't
limit, baby.
Already. If you've already seen it, you don't need to see it twice. Nines. I'll let them go. If the king was an ace and if the five was a king, I would consider
Hopefully
it, but...
Someone could...
Yeah, that ace is scary.
Now this is where all
ten high straight. I would have had nothing that could have beaten that, so I would have lost. Good fold. Good fold, Derek. Count Pat on the back. Pat on the back. Alright, there's some high cards here. But I have a 9 and a king, so I don't really like it. We'll let Scotty win. Scotty win. I've done that multiple times, actually. I will call. Me versus Scotty, and I'm definitely in the lead here. This is Raz?
Let's
yes, it is.
This party started, okay?
When you're
yeah,
hot, you're
he
hot.
Has to fold there. Alright, Jack Queen. It folds to me, and remember, Kim is super tight. And she's showing a king. And I'm showing a 5. I raise here. She thinks that her hand is beaten before it even starts, and she'll fold. Yeah, perfect.
Oh, man. Another one?
So even though my hand wasn't necessarily good, I still won the pot. Alright, let's try to get the queen or the king isolated. I bet Megan calls, though.
Oh,
good. Thank goodness.
Another
so we're just winning the Raz. I like that. We just win the Raz straight out. We're up to 90-ish thousand, which is beautiful. We're in a good spot right now, and now the antes are starting to take effect. Small blind, big blind, antes, they're all doing their part. And I wish we were still playing Raz. Getting some good Raz starting hands here.
Another win!
10 queen. I'll raise, mostly because Brian and Skip are short stacked.
He scared everybody away.
And they are more likely to fold. Nice. Aggression is just helping us out here. This is beautiful. I'm actually going to fold this. Megan scares me, and I'm not going to get involved with her. Mostly because she has a normal size chip stack. Ooh, I like this. We have 3 spades, and I didn't see any spades out there. That's beautiful. So now we're going to have the second high nut flush, which is great. I'm going to raise. He's going to re-raise. That whole deal. I'm going to check and slow it down. The pot's mighty. Big enough to me already. I just need one more spade, 2 more cards to come. Ooh, there's an ace. That's helpful. But I do need a spade here. Pretty good chance. There it is.
Hey, let's keep it interesting.
Now I'm going to raise.
Awesome.
And he folds. He thinks I got it or something. I don't know. That was weird. I don't know why he would do that. Again, Kim, very tight. I'm showing an ace. She's showing a 3. I will raise. And I have a good chance for a low card, too. A low hand. So, I will fold this one. 115,000. Yes.
23 skadoo.
23 skadoo.
Ah, good bet. It's all yours.
We're doing good. We're doing good so far. I think we went really, really deep in horse last year. Ooh, high-low split, and we already show a pair of 5s. I like that. We'll call. Alright, so I'm going to raise here. He's going to have a low. Okay. And right now I've got a pair of 5s. Yeah, he's going to raise because he has a low for sure, and he knows that he's at least winning half. So I need to win. Ooh, I don't know. He's got the low. He's winning half for sure.
He wants to see the next card.
I just need to win high.
That's good.
Yeah, that 2 didn't help me. Oh, I don't like this. I don't like giving money to Skip. Oh man, I need a king, jack, or 9. And it's a 3. That was bloody worthless. Hopefully he doesn't have a straight. Let's see. This could be very bad for me. I think he's got a straight. Oh no, good. Okay, perfect. So we do split. Whew. That's another reason I kind of went with it, because, sometimes you're just right. There we go. Top pair. good kicker.
No biggie.
I will call. Remember last time we played up heads up against Hugh, he had us beat. So we need to be careful. I'm actually going to raise here, play the spades. I don't have a king or an ace of spades, so if another spade hits, I will be very nervous. Okay, I'm going to raise, because he's checking the river. In Texas Hold'em especially, I feel like I'm winning. Yeah.
10-6,
I had jack, yeah. Good raise there. Alright, queen 8. Under the gun, let's fold it, let's let it go. We can lower our percentage a bit here. Now we're in the big blind, 4-10. We'll let them battle it out. We don't need to be involved in this. Yoo-hoo. Alright, ace 10, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. I'm going to re-raise. I would be very happy putting Skip Cole all in pre-flop.
Awesome.
Nice, we just scoop up some easy money.
I'm folding this one.
That was wonderful. 5-6-9. Since there's really nothing to talk about other than poker gameplay, I'm gonna kind of go over what I'm watching, because I watch a lot of TV. So on Netflix, I really have nothing. I finished up Psych, which I'm very sad is gone. Oh wow, what a great flop for our hand. But again, it's Omaha, and I could be beaten at any time. So I'm just going to be cautious and let the pot build. I'm going to let Hugh just bet into me. I'll finish talking about Psych after this hand.
Possible flushes.
Beautiful, so we have a full house. I'm actually going to raise. I think my king's up, or my king's full are good. Yeah. Nice. I finished up Psych, and that made me really sad. I actually did tear up a bit. Not in the final episode. The final episode was a bit goofy for me. But maybe two or three episodes before the final episode, the chief said goodbye. They all said their goodbyes. And, I mean, everyone was like, his dad was selling the house and all this other crazy stuff as Skip Cole gets eliminated. And, you know, it was a great show. And if you want to watch a show with your kids that I think is age-appropriate, and I would say for kids who are 10 years old and older, they can watch this show. Kind of as a precursor to CSI and stuff. So if you have a 10-year-old as a kid, or if you are a 10-year-old and you happen to be watching poker for some weird reason, or if you have a niece and a nephew and you want to connect with them a little bit, definitely watch this show, because I really cannot wait for my niece and nephew to watch this show. I would happily rewatch the whole series through with them, and I think it would be very fun. This is good. This is another good flop. 8, 9, 10, jack. A queen gives us a straight. A 8 or a king gives us a full house. A 9 gives us 4 nines, a quad nines. I mean, we've got really good odds here of winning, so we're going to continue here. Poor Brian. Poor Brian just has to fold. That doesn't change anything. I'm just going to call this time because I don't know what Hugh has. And he could have kings. He could have aces. I'll check. I think I'm winning.
All right. Nice. That's what I like to see.
So yeah, go watch Psych, because that was an amazing show. And if you didn't like Psych, you probably didn't like Monk either, which was pretty much what came before Psych. Oh good, Raz. I like Raz. And Suits and White Collar are probably the shows for you. Should I watch Suits and or White Collar? And if so, which one's better? Because they both look like the same show to me. So please, if anyone watches those and you happen to be watching this, can you explain the difference to me? Because I don't know. I don't know the difference between Suits and White Collar. It's like they're both criminals, they're both lawyers or something. It's very odd, it's very confusing.
Okay, one hand at a time.
I mean, right now we are just decimating this. Is it Raz still? It is. We're about to put Brian all in. High cards, high cards.
I'll get the next one.
Damn it.
I fold.
3-4. Oh, nice. So we just kind of win some money back there. One? 7 card, ace jack suited. I didn't see ace jack or spade, so I'm going to call here. Especially because I got them out chip stacked by 20-1. So, I mean, the odds are just good. I mean, I should just really put them all in. Which is what I'm going to do. Deuce 9 doesn't scare me. I've got Ace Jack under. So, yeah, Psych was really good, and I cried at the end of it. And it was, I mean, there was a lot of good episodes. There were some bad episodes, but there were really good episodes in there. And I appreciate what Psych did. They tried to be different and funny, and I mean, the connection between the cast was amazing. Lassiter was awesome. Alright, I'm going to raise here. I've got Scotty Wynn 11-1 in chip stack. Really almost kind of 10.5-1. I'm just going to keep raising him all in until he goes all in. Because I really do have him dominated here, I think. 3-4-10. I don't think he could really... Oh, he had kings under. Uh-oh.
All right.
Oh, that's good. What I like to see. We take out Scotty Wynn, a former winner of this Horse World Championship in real life. I think maybe 2008.
Scotty Wynn packs
I don't remember.
Bags, a one-way.
But Scotty Wynn is gone. Nice. Early knockout for the pro. High low? No. Just high.
Oh,
we're
going
to race. Kim, you want to go all in? I got a pair of sixes already. She does not. Everyone is scared. I've decimated this table.
Players are going to have to pay to see the cards.
And the show, the movie, the documentary I watched last night to prepare for this upcoming season of American Horror Story was, I think it was something serial killer, Eileen Wuornos. And she was the female serial killer, really the first female serial killer ever, I believe, that has kind of been thrust into the spotlight. And it was a really interesting documentary. Because really, I'm like... maybe 4/5 of the way through it, and I still don't know if she did it or not. I'm still confused. It's kind of like, did she do it? Yeah, but then, like, when she thought she was off camera, she said, I didn't do it, but I have to pretend that I did. It's really, really weird. It's really weird. It's a weird story. So if you have about an hour and a half of your time, I would very much recommend that Eileen Wuornos documentary. It's interesting. I mean, this woman really does look innocent, and then suddenly she looks not innocent. It's so weird. It's so strange. And again, I mean, we're just decimating this table. The antis are destroying Kim. Brian is pretty much all in already, and Hugh is the only threat we have, but even he is in a bad spot here. Nothing connecting for Kim, and I do win... high and low. Nice. And that'll take out half the competition. So yeah, I watched that documentary last night and it was amazing. I didn't finish it, I fell asleep. But I do want to finish it tonight because I want to know what happened. I mean, they killed her. They actually killed this woman with the death penalty. So I'm really intrigued at how... So I know the ending, kind of, but I'm really intrigued to see... how she went. Did she go in peace? Did she go screaming? Did she go cussing?
He'll
I
check.
Mean, it was an intense documentary. All right, we only have a pair of sixes here. There's a couple aces. I'm scared of Russell. We'll fold. Ace four. I shall check. Lindsay Russell. Hugh Rogers, Russell Grubbs, Chandler Cooper, Brian Wallace, and Betty Jo Summers. Alright, 668 left now.
Well, that's
Ace Deuce 3-4, I love that. Give me a 5, and I will love it even more. 8,000 is worth either hitting an ace or a 5, I believe.
Board shows a pair of
even a 10, I think, because now it makes me not think that they have a 10. Ooh, okay, now I do. You've convinced me with your raise, re-raise, 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 re-raise. Quad tens. Yeah, I believe you, Hugh. I believe you.
I'll call.
9-3, not good, we'll fold. So yeah, so let me know what you're watching on Netflix, because I really need some stuff to watch. And I'm not going to guarantee that I will watch what you suggest. Because I'm a very particular person, but yeah, especially like Suits or White Collar, which one should I watch? I'm leaning towards Suits. Because White Collar, I mean, the funny character in White Collar doesn't appeal to me as much as the funny bad guy character in Suits.
No biggie.
So, I also really want to watch,
Sugar, if you're looking for a good time,
what's the one on USA Network that they don't... Oh, not USA, the one on...
That's it for me.
ABC, I think it's CBS. The one on CBS, Elementary. The Elementary is the Sherlock Holmes series, and they don't have it on Netflix. I'm wondering if they have it on Hulu. I'll check tonight, but if they have it on Hulu, I'll definitely watch the whole series. I've only seen the first season and, like, maybe 5 episodes of the second season. So,
some hearts out there.
6, 7, I don't have an 8. I only have 9s in Queens, and I think it might be enough. I don't believe he has a queen. And if he has a 9, I've got a good kicker. Ah, he did. Okay. Well done. So yeah, that's what I'm planning. I'm either going to watch Elementary on Hulu or something else on Netflix. So, probably White Collar. I'll look for Suits first, but if I don't find it, which would be strange, I'll just start White Collar.
Ah, good bet. It's all
Burn
yours.
Notice was really good, too. I liked Burn Notice.
I'm solving this one.
I think one of my favorite series ever was called The Shield, with
some pretty faces out there.
With a lot of people, actually.
Especially if you paired one, Norman.
Yeah, I don't even want to say it. So there's a lot of people in that are really good, and it's
Let's
a great
see,
show. It's old, it's gritty. I mean, I really wish I had watched that when it came out.
Here
made by
the
same guy, or made from the same mindset of the guy from Sons of Anarchy.
I'm not sure that...
And Sons of Anarchy was awesome. So, okay, I'm done talking about Netflix. A little bit of Netflix talk, you know, to kind of lighten
like
the
money.
Poker mood.
Like,
Let's get back to poker.
Well, not this one.
657... individuals left. We're still in a great spot here. Hugh and Lindsay battling it out. Oh man. Lindsay goes all in and loses. Double knockout. Oh man, that's crazy. I'll call.
I call.
Wow. We're really progressing in this tournament, and it makes me super happy. Ace 5. I have nothing that connects really here. Okay. 9-10. So I have 10 queen. A jack would be good. Ooh, king. King, I think he might have hit the king. I'm going to let it go. I have nothing on that board. King 10, deuce 8. I like the king 10. But I don't like the deuce 8. Let's let Chandler take care of Betty Joe.
I'm out. These are the moments that can really
Oh, good.
Put
wow,
a
what a great hand for Chandler Cooper. He's got ace king suited and
chips.
Pocket tens. She has a pretty good hand, too, though. Nines, ace four, hearts, spades.
Jack.
Deuce seven. Two clubs. Beautiful for Chandler Cooper.
The jack of spades.
Another jack, and that's...
Hand in the game, but more
I mean, she needs
not,
a 9.
Good
a 9 or an
Last
ace
stop, everybody off.
That's not a club. Queen doesn't help, and Betty Jo Summers gone. Chandler Cooper in a very nice outfit,
that's
might I say,
analogy,
taking out
poker,
Betty Jo Summers. Deuces! Sixes! I think I'm just going to re-raise Russell all in. We'll try to end this now.
Oh, man.
Nice. He folded. Raz, beautiful. I raise. I'll take you out. I mean, right now we got a 7 deuce, which is beautiful. I love it. I love the hand. Okay, he hits a queen. He hits a 10. Oh, he's got a 3. Okay, good. He's got queen 10.
Right.
I win. Nice. And we blast through that table. That's awesome. We're so good right now. I love it.
Table fills up with new players.
Mike Louder, Montel Green, Renata Bigsby, Betsy Edwards. We're still playing Raz. 8-9. We get a call from Betsy. There's a couple kings and a jack there, so I'm going
to
call as well. We'll see if we can outdraw Betsy here. 10. I check. Chandler with the king actually called. That's interesting. Oh, I hit a king. I don't like it. I feel like Betsy's got the best hand. Chandler definitely could have had the best hand, too. I mean, he could have ace three under the two hidden cards, so we'll let it go. Still Raz, we have 3-7. I'm actually going to raise here. I see three big cards, and I see Montel Green who will fold. Yes. Wonderful. I'm just going to continue to raise. Whittle down Chandler Cooper. This is great. He's got King, Queen, Jack. I mean, as long as I get a fifth card, I think I'm winning. And he realizes that, and he folds. All right, I'm gonna continue to attack him. I see a lot of low cards. Almost everybody had a low card showing. So if I raise here, maybe they call, and we get a big pot. Okay, this is scary, so I'm gonna check. We'll wait. Now. We'll see what Chandler gets. He hits a jack. Right now, I've got an 86 if I hit something lower than an 8. And right now, he's got a jack something. Okay, so he's beating me right now, so I'm going to still slow it down. Okay, so I hit the jack now. Now, he's got jack 9 most likely, and I've got jack 8 most likely, so I'm going to raise 1/10 of his whole stack. Let's see if he puts it in. All right, give me a 7 or even a 5 would be good. I like the 5, so now I've got an 86. We're going to whittle down Chandler Cooper here. Oh, he raises. Ooh. Ooh. I win. 86 beats 96. The 5 helped him, too. Wow. All right. So it's Raz. We've got pocket 10s and a king. We're going to fold. So we whittled down Chandler Cooper. Good. Who's next? Hugh? Hugh needs to be next on our list. Was he an original, Hugh? I feel like he was. I feel like Hugh was an original.
I love that sound. Clink, clink, clink. Your chips dropping in on my stack. Right.
7 card stud. We'll fold it. We shall fold.
Two players took a shot.
Montel
and
Green
up,
takes a huge
hand.
Now Mike Lauder, also in danger. So yeah, this is going to be the table where we really have to step it up and play a little more and take some of these people out. I think next time we will go to 108. I want to say no. It wouldn't go down that far. I bet it'll go to 216. The next table will go down to 216. So two more tables to clear before we make the money.
Start, but a disappointing finish.
Welcome to All right, so we got 7 card stud. I don't see... Oh, I see 1 diamond. I'm just going to call.
One time.
All right, so we have a low here.
He'll let somebody else jump first.
And a low is good, especially three-handed.
I'll call this one.
We'll call. Renata scares me because she has that ace. Ooh, and now the 4, I think, beats me. 6-4. Yeah, that beats me. So I got a fold. Damn it.
Well, not this one. Well, guess I can.
Nothing was really
going
to connect for me there, and she probably had two
Let's
hearts
under. Let's take a look
under.
At what they're hiding.
Pocket 3s, I like it, especially when it's... 7 card stud. Oh, there is no low. Oh, I need to be careful of that. I thought there was a low. Right. I'm going to call. We're going to keep it slow against Betsy Edwards. We do not want to automatically double her up. There is no low. Ooh, she hits her 4s, which beats me. I'll call. Give me a 9, a queen, or a 3. And we do not hit it. She beat us, so let's not give her the extra 11,000.
Not finished yet.
Alright, 5-9 will fold. We can fold a little more. Let's check our percentage. 39. So yeah, we can go out a little less. Play a little less here and let them play it out. Just choose our spots. That's what we're going
to
be doing here.
He has to feel a little grateful to win. Heads up there, Norman.
Okay. Hugh, who is pretty tight, right?
They've made it all the way
here.
Yeah,
27%. Him and Mike Lauder. Is raising. That's interesting. I'll check. Let's see where you're at, Hugh. You're one of the people I need to whittle down.
Ooh, can't wait to see how this hand turns out. Call.
It's high, low. So we're building a low. That's great. But we need two more cards, two more consecutive low cards to get that low. So I'm just going to check again.
Somebody else can make it for you.
10 jack queen. A king?
Check, please.
Oh, I don't know. I don't think he's got a low either. And I've got jacks. I don't know if that's good enough.
Well, he couldn't do much about that. Norman.
Aces, damn it. Yeah. That's what made me nervous. I was nervous that he had some huge pocket pair. Damn it.
I fold.
Joe Hashem in the lead right now. Montel Green close behind Pat Hublow in third. Montel can take chip lead with this win. And when he loses, he'll drop off that top three. Alright, we'll fold. We'll stop messing around. We'll go back to what we know, which was Hold'em and Raz.
I'm on fire.
Unless we get something awesome.
No thanks.
Alright, Montel Green gonna develop himself into a chip bully.
Ooh, you just got Affleck.
He does win. Ace Jack 6. I like that. I'm actually gonna re-raise because I want Mike Lauder all in. I want
Clemens
his chips.
Makes his mark.
Yes. I call. I've got him covered by quite a bit here, by 180,000. I raise. About 60% of his stack. He'll go all in. I will call. No spade. Oh, the king is scary, but no spade. Yes. Yes, I did win. Right on the river, too. That's what I wanted. I wanted his chip stack. I needed that, I feel like.
Good bet. It's all yours.
I needed to absorb him. Chandler Cooper and Betsy Edwards are next. They're the next two I want to absorb.
Brought to you by Wrigley's.
Oh, beautiful. Oh, yes.
Hey, I'm in.
60,000 already. There we go. We got top pair. I mean, this is great. We just need to be careful that we're not going to get blindsided by something.
Hey,
10 jack is what I'm talking about at this point.
Let's see what's up next.
Good.
Courtesy
we win.
Of the Wrigley's next.
All right, how are we're going 318. Okay.
Someone.
Let's see if any of the players will get some relief. Here's the
8-6 offsuit. No, thank you.
Players will turn.
No double knockout here.
Now.
10-9, queen
Eight.
9. Montel needs a 10 to knock out Betsy. Doesn't happen. Double up, and not a very big one. Betsy in trouble. 5-4, jack 3.
That's a sinking.
Oh, there's a jack. She doubles again.
Has two pair now.
All right, 10 king. I'm going to fold, only because Hugh is in the big blind, and he could call with anything.
Hopefully so. Forge. Pop.
Yeah, these two monster chip stacks battling it out. 4-5-6-7. It's not double suited. It's total rainbow. I'll check. Yeah, I'll see a free flop. Sure, if it's like,
someone could
if it's
good.
6-7-8-9-10 jack. I don't like it. I don't like the bottom end of straights. I'll fold. Yeah. Oh, Chandler Cooper gone. I didn't even notice he was in the hand. 5-7 jack 8. I don't like it, so I'll fold. And where are we at? We're down to 283. Oh, it's going to be way lower. It's definitely probably going to be 108 people left, I imagine. That's weird, though. I don't know, actually. We'll see. We'll see what happens when a couple more of these people get eliminated. This is very interesting. Ace, queen, 9-10. I like it. Let's re-raise and try to isolate.
Let's see what they
beautiful.
Got.
Ace, 9, 7-5. So I've got the advantage here, I think. She has a club flush that could beat me.
3-6-10.
Okay, so the 10 hits me, but
the
gives her a
of
lot
spades.
Of straight opportunities.
Lemons.
King of spades doesn't
of
help her.
Here to win the hand.
Last call.
Yeah,
that's it.
I've got a
no
huge
more.
Advantage here. There's a queen, and I think that hits me as well. Oh no, Okay, we're good. I think I just bumped it. And we win. Betsy Edwards is gone. 251st place. Ace, king, 3-8. Double suited. I like that. There's I'm going to raise. 250 left.
Nothing interesting
there. Ooh, not the ones I wanted, but I have two pair. So I'm going to raise again. We are identically chip stacked. So I'm going to be very aggressive here. I have two pair. An 8 or a 3 is awesome. Ace or a king just improves. Beautiful. We got it. I don't think there's anything that he can do to beat me here.
Awesome.
Nice.
I'm out.
All right, 3, queen, king, and it's Raz. That's no good. I check. Let's see if we can get better here. 4's good. I check. Renata being very cautious against me. She knows I'm the Raz king. 3, 4, 5 is good. But even her 10-8 beats my king, queen. So, yeah, see, so she's going to win here, and she knows it.
Well, that's what you do when you don't think bluffing will work.
All right, 8-3 is good, so I will raise. Nice, we just take it down. 7-king. The king is bad, but I'm going to re-raise. I want Renata out of this tournament. Oh, that's no good. I check. That's bad. Oh, she got lucky. She hit her cards, and I did not hit mine.
Looks like he was in position to play, but then he got rid of his cards.
Maybe he's trying to plant the idea that he shoots at pots with weak hands.
3-4. I like it. We'll raise. Especially if it goes to Hugh. I would love to knock Hugh out. Renata, I believe I can beat, but Hugh scares me because he's so tight.
Yes.
Fact, actually, he's hit doing more than Renata at this point. But I think it's because she was low chip stacked.
I felt that pot was a little lonely.
Well, they keep it company.
We're
going to
try to take chip lead at this table here. And so far so good, although we have king queen right now, and that's bad. Oh, now that's really bad. I've got a fold. I hit my 3. That sucks. Raz did not do well for us in this tournament, or in this round, did it? Again, I mean, with these kings, this sucks.
Checks all around.
Oh my god. I'm just getting outdrawn here.
Renata Bixby has to be very happy with how she...
7-card stud, I fold.
She just keeps raking in the pots.
She is gaining here. I will actually contend with king, queen suited and a jack of diamonds. Oh, good. No lows to allow you to escape my clutches of jacks. They'll both fold. A re-raise. A re-raise. Why would you re-raise? A 10 gives me a straight here. I check. Why would you re-raise me? Well, now I have two pairs, so even if you have aces under, that's not going to help you. I've got a raise. I've got to.
Hey, let's keep it interesting at least.
What could you have? Sixes?
All right.
Aces, like exactly. Beautiful. A re-raise. Why did she do that? She just kind of telegraphed what her hand was. 7-card stud, I'm showing ace. Let's let Montel Green take care of this. I don't want to lose my money.
I love that sound.
There you go. There it is.
Plenty of players, including some
oh, day two. Exciting.
Player of the year.
Scott Fishman has a narrow.
Alright. So, day two. We're going to continue on because, I mean, my new kind of strategy for my videos is not only 1-hour videos and not like 2 a day, but they'll come out when they come out. What is that? Why is that up?
And here to strike
Why is this
into
up?
The hearts of everyone else at the
I don't
table.
Know. I must have Phil hit troubleshoot or something. Phil Hellmuth. Oh no, day two we're matched up with Phil Hellmuth here.
Why in the world
How's it going, pal? I got pocket queens under to start out. We're gonna try to take the lead here. Oh, we can't. Montel Green's at 7. It's going to be difficult, but I think we can do it. I'm going to raise. We're playing against Phil Hellmuth. 168 remaining. This, I believe, is where we went out last time. 3 queens. We're golden. Let me look at my history.
Hey,
I might have recorded it.
The stalky's doing the betting. I'm doing the calling.
You hear what he calls me, people. He's so mean. That's so weird. Why would he do that?
All right.
I call. Okay. I don't think I recorded where I went in the... Oh, now you know you lost because I hit my full house, you jerk.
Awesome.
He does call. Yes, he's high. Oh my god. He missed. What was he going for? A queen? He was looking for a straight? Oh my god. Oh, he's so angry. He's so mad at me right now. You can only imagine. He must be so angry.
That's it for me.
All right, well, I didn't record what place I got. So if we're probably going to beat it. All right, me versus chip leader at the table. 20 people left. I check. I don't have a hand. It doesn't look like you've got a hand yet either. Ooh, I've got kings. I'll bet those. Oh, he re-raises me. Interesting. I check. If you think you've got me beat, I check. The spade scares me. So I only have kings. I check, and then I'll probably call whatever you raise. King high. What are these people doing? I don't get it. I don't understand. Are they playing Raz? They're not supposed to be playing Raz. It's 7-card high-low split here. This is the big boy table, and he's actually going to beat me here, I think. Yeah, he'll raise. Let him win the small pot. I don't care. I don't give a damn. I just beat him and Phil Hellmuth in 2 pretty huge pots. We'll fold until we get to a better game that I like to play.
I must be feeling generous.
So we're still to 160. I imagine we'll have to eliminate somebody to make that go any lower. That's okay. That's fine. I feel like we're in a good position. Yeah, and we'll fold this one as well. So we're playing against Phil Hellmuth. That's exciting. Day 2. He's mad at us, though, because we beat him. He was bluffing. There you go. There's a good pot for you, Phil. Ace-King's pretty good. I'm going to call because it might isolate Virginia, and I've got her covered by, looks like to be about 500,000, so. Nice. You know what? I'm going to raise.
Hey, let's keep it interesting at least.
1, maybe 11th of Virginia's chip stack. She raises me. Interesting. She checks. I'm going to raise. I have aces, and I have 3 spades. She doesn't know it, but a jack helps me, a 10 helps me, a lot of things help me here. An 8 helps me. I'll check. Let's see what you got. I'll forestall your execution.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yep.
Count me out.
So I didn't want to be the one to take her out. I should have, but I was a little nervous that I was beat and she was
all
just faking it.
Ace
deuce versus ace 3. Oh, gross. Oh, gross. Don't. A 5. A spade. Ooh.
That's what we were shooting for.
Look how sad she is. Oh, she's so sad. Oh, now she's
sometimes
normal again. She was really sad there for a minute. Deuce 3. We'll fold. We're down to 156. We're gonna cash. That's awesome. Because that means that we have enough money to play the main event. And it means we don't have to borrow money from people.
And he bets.
That's exciting.
Well.
Alright, Hugh. I raise.
Lemons will be the first one to stir the pot.
I'll get on board.
Hugh calls. Ooh, a queen is bad. I don't like that. I'm going to raise again.
This party started, okay?
And he folds. Good. I was nervous. Now 5, 6, 7 would have been even worse. Because he could have had an 8. Oh, well, ooh, we're going to break 100. We're going to break... What is that, a million? Yeah, that's a million. We're going to break 1 million chips.
The next card cam.
That's exciting. I don't think we've done that before.
Lemons?
Over 800. 156 still remaining. I want to see the leaderboard. Give me the leaderboard. Phil Hellmuth advice. Let's see. Fold a low pair if raised after
Ford
the flop.
Shows
yeah.
A pair of vibes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 7, 4, 5.
Let's see if any of the players will get some relief. Here's the next card.
Right. Omaha, sixes and sevens. I like it. I'll call. Leader, Sharon Payne, 966. 955 for Billy Bob and Newt Carter, 944. So I'm about 100,000 off of the leader.
Some pretty fa-
I check. Check.
Board shows a pair of jacks.
Ooh.
All right.
I will call. That doesn't change anything. I will call. Hopefully my sevens beat whatever he has.
I waited a long time to
Does not. He had a jack. Well, good job. He bet exactly what he had, too. He wasn't bluffing or anything. I'll call just on the off chance I hit an 8.
Flop on its own doesn't mean much of anything.
Okay, I didn't. I'm going to let Hugh win it. Minimize your losses, people. King Jack 8-3. Nothing to be excited over. Dan Needham wins with aggression. 3, 4, 7, 9. Again, nothing to be excited over.
Good mood, so I'll let you have it.
We will fold. Similar chip stacks here. These guys have been battling for quite some time. I think Hugh is an original.
This is where all that practice.
So, I mean, that's really rare that an original gets this far with us.
Once out.
And if he's not an original, he for sure is table 2. Our second table. So... I mean, that's even that is impressive. Raz, beautiful. I raise. Remember that Phil Hellmuth won his 10th bracelet, I think. 11th, 12th, I think it was 10th. At Raz this past year.
Let's get this party started.
But we're playing against Grant, and he has King 10. Okay, I fold. I don't fold, but I will slow it down considerably.
And he'll call.
3, 4, 5, 7. So I need something less than 3, or a 6, or even an 8, anything to beat that 10.
Awesome.
Oh, he folds. Good. Alright, deuce 4. I'm going to re-raise Phil Hellmuth. He's going to be so mad at me. Phil Hellmuth would call me a fish or a donkey for sure. He hits his 2s, I hit my 10. I'll check.
Please.
I think we're both in trouble. Okay. Oh, he wins. yeah, that wasn't good.
Let's take a look at what they're hiding.
What's gross about Raz is I probably still could have won that hand if I got super lucky.
Now let me show you what the Hellmuth wall looks like.
The Hellmuth wall. You'll have to show me after this hand, because right now I've got a 95 and you have a 10-6. I'll check. You improved, I did not. Ooh, I've got a queen 9. I'll check. Ah, gross, I check.
I'll check it.
Probably lost it, yeah.
Act like the best.
Ah.
Nope.
That's good advice. If you want to be the best, act like the best. He's gonna play though. We'll let these guys battle it out.
Down without a fight, mate, so expect a
7 card stud, and we have a couple kings. That's great. I'm gonna isolate and try to take out Grant. So he has tens. Oh, he has spades. Damn it. Ah, damn it. I had him beat to the 7th street.
I fold.
Damn, we'll fold. Phil, what are you doing? What are you doing, Phil? He's got an ace and 4s. Phil, you're gonna lose, man.
Ooh, you just got
oh my god. 4s over 10s. He got blindsided. He lost a lot of his money. I don't know what he's thinking. We'll get a free fourth street here. We hit an ace. He hits a seven. High-low? No, not high-low. Take it.
Just isn't my time.
We get a free fourth street, so why not?
That's good.
Why not? Alright, I'm going to raise here. I think my king nine is better than whatever he has hidden. I don't think the seven helped him, but I mean, I could be wrong. I'm just trying to bluff here, really. I actually got a good hand. Although he has three clubs, that scares me. I check. I'm very nervous. I'm very nervous. He hit two pair or something stupid.
I love that sound. Cling,
God
cling,
damn it.
Your chip's dropping in on my stack.
So he had nothing. He hit sevens when I hit kings. Or I had kings when he had sevens, and I beat him. And then on the
players
final card, he beat me. Yeah.
Really gonna feel the burn.
That's gross.
Soon.
Is this... No, it's not high-low. That's... Come on. Give me high-low. Jesus. Montel Green, over a million chips. That's crazy. Alright, I've got to call this, actually. I mean, I've got a backdoor club. I've got eights. This is high-low. Okay. So he's definitely not going to have a low, but he's got two pair. So I'm really screwed. God damn it. 6, 7, 8. I'm going to re-raise. I'm going to re-raise them all in again. I'm going to try to knock him out. I'll call. A lot of money, but we'll see if we can win it here. Oh, Jesus.
Lemons?
I'm pushing you all in. You've got queens, you're gonna call. Why wouldn't you?
Well, I congratulate you. You outplayed me.
I'll fold until I get to Raz or Hold'em. I'm not gonna not cash in this damn tournament. I spent an hour and 12 minutes. I am not going to lose right now because of these silly-ass draws that are happening. Not going to happen. Not against these jabronis. I'm turning into Phil Hellmuth now. That's what's gross. I'm actually calling because this is a great low-card hand. Okay, now I have a pair of twos. I'm going to keep the pot low. As much as I can. 7-6 deuce ace, so I have a 76. I'll call the 50.
The next card.
Give me a 3. 3, 4, 5.
Jack's
I need
good.
A queen. God damn it.
I will call, baby.
Oh, 4. Thank God. 76 is our low. But we have nothing else of... 76. Okay, so let's say he has ace-deuce-4. Ace-deuce-4. He's gotta have that. If he doesn't... Oh my god, he could still beat me. Gross. I just wanna split. Give me 200,000. I'll be happy.
Let me tell you something. You wanna play poker
thank god.
For living especially as bad as you are, you better get a backup plan.
Ooh. Ooh, that's what I wanted. I wanted to split that pot. I was looking for the low, which is dangerous, right?
Let's see if any of the players...
Ace 9. I don't like it. Not against them.
Players.
Ace high straight. Wow, I had an ace 2.
Cool.
Alright, ace 5. I'm gonna call. It's cheap for me.
Board shows a pair of queens.
Check fold. Check fold.
And they drop out.
Ace 9 for Phil wins it.
On, so waiting for that.
4-10, we're going to fold. The antes are kicking us in our ass right now. We need someone to bust out immediately or something. Oh, this is gross. This is sick.
Next,
we're not going to cash. Do I play it? No. Be safe. I'm going full Daniel Negreanu mode here. Be safe.
Damn, baby. I'm on fire.
I think this is a great hand. I'm actually going to go all in.
local.
Or at least as far all in as I can. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have done that. I'm
gonna
be mad as a hornet if I lose this. What does Hugh have? 8-6-3-deuce. Aren't you a piece of work? Aren't you a piece of work? 9.
The three of hearts.
Yeah, that's fuck out of here. Made a move. Damn it.
Some outs.
You must be joking. We come that close again and then we blow up. That's so gross. That's so gross. Well, in a last-ditch effort, I'll be playing this one offline right now. I'm in a pissed-off mood. It's so sick. David Ulliott, Gavin Smith, Scott Fishman, Phil Locke. Alright. Oh, I'm mad. That makes me so mad. I always do so well in horse, and then I bust before the bubble. Always. So we got some money there, I guess. Yeah, we didn't do very good in that one. Ugh. Alright, well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Super long episode. But another deep run, right? I mean, we're playing good poker. It's just... what are you gonna do? We lost. Phil Hellmuth beat us. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Derek D. Ginger King, checking out.